Hi everyone, Aaron here for Zolotech, and iOS 14 Beta 1 has been out for, well, almost a couple weeks at this point, and I've also been running iOS 13.6 Beta 3. So I have iOS 13.6 Beta 3 on my iPhone 11 and iOS 14 Beta 1 on my iPhone 11 Pro Max. So I have a case on the 11, it's just an Apple case with a screen protector, and so I wanted to talk about how both of them have been. So let's first talk about iOS 13.6. Now 13.6 Beta 3 brings a few features, and I talked about that in my iOS update video of what's new. And really, most people are saying there's no bugs in this. So expect it to perform fluidly, not really have any issues, have everything be super smooth, and just basically what you would expect from an iOS 13 release. In fact, iOS 13, this particular update, we may see a further beta. So in fact, we may see a beta maybe this coming week along with iOS 14, those sort of things, but I'm not really sure at this point what Apple's planning for this, but I would expect mid to late July for an iOS 13.6 release to the public, so expect it sometime around that point. There's not a whole lot more to say about it other than that most people are saying that battery has been basically the same on iOS 13.6 betas as it was with iOS 13.5.1. So there's not a whole lot to say about it, and in fact, most people are not very excited about iOS 13.6. However, with iOS 14 Beta 1, it's been pretty good. In fact, I've been using it full-time, and I've been changing it around. If you've watched my recent videos, you'll see that the widgets have moved around, and I've been using this as my main device, and it keeps picking very odd pictures for me on this photo here. It's a very close selfie, but I really like this new layout, and I've been using it full time and changing it around to see how it actually works for me. So you'll see there's the current temperature. It's pretty warm out here. And then there's a podcast. So that's really nice, but I have been having some weird issues with it. So I wanted to talk about the issues I've been having with it. Then I'll talk about issues you've been having about with it, and then talk about performance, battery life, and talk about the YouTube community poll where I took all of this information to see what you had to say about it. Now, the first thing is I've been having Wi-Fi and cellular act strange. Now I'm outside, so obviously I don't have Wi-Fi. I'm not near my house, so that kind of gives you an idea that I probably don't have Wi-Fi, although I guess I could, depending where you're at. Now, I've been having weird load times with Safari, so if I go to Safari, maybe we'll take a look at the iPhone SE. I don't have great signal where I'm at right now, so you'll see it is loading. Seems to be okay, but sometimes it will just freeze, and I actually have to turn Wi-Fi off and on again, but right now it seems to be working properly. Now, also, I have that storage bug, so if you go to General, and then you go to your iPhone storage, you'll see that it's using a tremendous amount of storage. So right now it's using 245.5 gigabytes on my iPhone 11 Pro Max out of 256. So it could be better, but it's using a tremendous amount. Next update, I expect it to go down, and I'll talk about when to expect that in just a moment. But the other thing I've been having is random freezes sometimes. Sometimes it just won't work properly. It'll go to load, and then it sort of just freezes, and then it picks back up. So it's been working okay, but I have had that issue. Many of you have noticed the same thing. Also, I talked about recently how AirDrop wasn't working great. Sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't. So if I'm trying to AirDrop to a device, if I AirDrop to the iPhone 11, for example, we'll wait for it to load here. Sometimes it works, it says waiting, and then other times it just doesn't work at all. And then I have to reboot the phone in order to get it to work. Now you'll see that the wallpaper just popped up on this phone, so that's working, and we'll talk more about some other things in a moment. But the other thing is, some apps are not working. So for example, some people are saying Pokemon Go or Pokemon Go is not working at all. So you can't play that. I have certain apps of mine that just won't open. And sometimes they just crash. So they'll open, crash right away, and they're not working properly. Other times they will, but it's kind of hit or miss. Now, finally, I want to talk about battery life, because I did a poll a week or so ago when this came out for the first follow-up, and people were saying that battery is really hit or miss. So it really depends on what you're doing, but in general, battery is not as great as it was on the public release, and I don't really expect it to be great. It's sort of a low priority on a beta, especially an early beta. You'll see my battery health is 97%. And if we take a look at the last 10 days, or we can take a look at yesterday, I used 50% of my battery and 3 hours and 31 minutes of screen on time, 3 hours and 5 minutes of screen off time. So really I'm only getting 6 to 7 hours of screen on time, and I used to get 10 to 12. So with an early beta, I don't really put that against it because it's not a priority. People need to develop their apps against it, and Apple says not to put it on your main device anyway. So that's why the public betas take a little bit longer to come out. So other than the freezing and lag that you've mentioned, many people are saying that the widgets are not working right. And I see this from time to time. So you'll see it says Charlotte now, but then other times it will say Cupertino. So if you go into it, it works fine. You'll see where I'm at now. It just doesn't work properly all of the time. So just keep in mind that that can be an issue. Right now, it's okay. Again, it's a beta, so I don't really expect it to be much of an issue. Performance seems to be okay, but expect occasional freeze-ups and lags, especially on some older devices. People are seeing that. But in general, it's been pretty good. But other than that, not many of you are having too many issues. Performance seems to be good on 13.6 beta 3 and also on beta 1, so nothing really there. And then in general, it's just been really solid for 13.6, and expect that soon. But iOS 14, I would expect a beta pretty soon. In fact, let's take a look at the calendar here. I have it on this screen. So I would expect the beta probably on Monday or Tuesday based off what they've done in the past. And then you can expect the public beta to come out at the exact same time. So expect similar sort of time frames compared to what we had before. I went over this in a video the other day. Then of course expect a public release in late September or early October. Now here are all of the issues mentioned in the YouTube community poll. So there's quite a few of you that mentioned battery, whether that's good or bad. This just is the word battery and what it's being searched as. And not many people mentioning RAM management, so that's a good sign. Multitasking seems to be good, but there are some people having issues with mail. So mail seems to be having those same issues that people were having before. Thankfully, I haven't had too many, but occasionally it just won't work properly. Unread mail won't show up just by itself if you select the options. And what I mean by that with the mail is when you go into it, if you have email in your email account and you select this little unread button down here in the bottom left, sometimes you'll still have email that's already been read. So it's the only issue I'm having with it, but other people are having the same old mail issues. So hopefully they fix this by the time it's released. Now here are all of the devices you're using in this particular community poll, and quite a few of you are using iPhone 11s now, iPhone XR, iPhone X, so we'll take a look at some of the older devices such as iPhone 7 in future videos as well. Now let's take a look at the YouTube community poll. Now this community poll went live not too long ago, but you can see over 6,200 people have voted, and there's over 300 comments at this point. So I've read all of the comments and took into account everything you've said. That's what I've showed you in the video earlier on. So right now you'll see 22% of you are on iOS 14 beta 1, 6% are on iOS 13.6 beta 3, and 57% of you are on iOS 13.5.1 or older. So basically the public release, and 15% of you are on Android. I know a lot of you ask me, why do I include Android? But the simple reason is I like to include everyone that's using everything. Maybe they like Android better. Maybe they're aspiring to get an iPhone. Maybe you're aspiring to get an Android phone. I just like to kind of include everyone because I do update videos for Android as well. Now, as you can see, there's 309 comments. Let's go ahead and sort this to newest first and take a look at some of them. iOS 13.6 beta 3, no major issues on my 11 Pro Max. I'm noticing delays on email syncing. When a new message arrives, I'll tap the notification, and then the email doesn't show in my inbox until I force it to sync. Has been great on my 7 Plus, battery life way better than iOS 13.6 beta, no reboots, no crashes, haven't found any apps that don't work, widgets could use some work. Having to quit to resize is a pain and need to be able to use third-party widgets, otherwise great. And speaking of third-party widgets, expect those in the future. Apple is now just creating this, so developers need to get out there, create their widgets, and you probably won't see a whole lot until this releases to the public. I'm on iOS 14 beta 1 on my 11 Pro Max. It seems to be very stable so far. The battery life doesn't seem to be a lot worse than iOS 13, probably the weather widget updating in the background, but pretty good so far. So a quick note about widgets. In fact, widgets do not update in the background any more than they would normally. In fact, it's up to the developer to determine how often they update. So it's possible it's updating, but it's also possible that it's something else. Using iOS 13.6 beta 3 on my iPad Pro 2018 11-inch and iPhone 11 Pro Max, battery life doing well, no bugs at all, and thanks for the compliment. iOS 13.5.1, and unfortunately, I still got the 6S Plus. It's not unfortunate, you'll be able to get iOS 14. So that's good news for you. You can keep up to date, and that phone's a great phone. Just keep replacing the battery as needed, and you'll be good to go. iOS 14 Beta 1 on my 8 Plus, and it's running quite smoothly for a first beta. iOS 14 Beta 1 on my iPhone XR, it's been great. I'm hoping the developers will update their Today view to fix the names. I've been using iOS 14, and my iPhone 7 Plus has been running smoothly, or smooth, and has been great overall. I've been using my iPad as well. It's been good. Has been a good update and running great, but there are some bugs, sometimes YouTube crashes and other apps, but it overall has been good. Using iOS 14 on iPhone 7, the only problem I have is inconsistent battery drain. Some days I will have approximately the same battery life as I had on iOS 13, and on other days the battery life is just plain terrible. iOS 14, iPhone 8, working great, good battery, good speed, only a few bugs here and there. Most notable bugs are the widgets don't update properly. The mail app starts weird, and sometimes the phone will lock up, but I haven't had to restart my phone yet, so it's been an overall positive experience. And I have had to restart this phone a couple times just to get things like AirDrop to work, so that's good news if you haven't had that issue. iPhone 6S, and it's running fantastic. Can't wait for the public beta. SE2 on iOS 14, working well for me overall. Music crashed a few times, and PowerBeats Pro sometimes disconnect. I get that disconnect either way, depending on what version I'm on, so I think that's just an issue with Bluetooth. iOS 14 Beta 1 on my iPhone 7 has been pretty good for the most part, except for a few crashes here and there. I'll read a couple more. iOS 14 Dev Beta 1 iPhone 8 Plus, it's been excellent, but having some overlay widget bugs in the widget section. iOS 13.5.1 on my iPhone 10, no issues whatsoever. Hi Aaron, Harry here from Australia, using iOS 14 Beta 1 on both iPhone 11 Pro Max and iPad Pro. It's been pretty good for a first beta. Hats off to Apple. And thanks to everyone that commented, I really appreciate it. And of course, expect this next update in a few days, and hopefully we'll see some big improvements, although it could go worse and then better again. You just never know at this point. But let me know if you've found any new features that I haven't mentioned in my other feature videos and things like that. I'd love to hear from you. And let me know which version you're going to install first, 13.6, or are you just going to jump to the public beta? I'd love to hear from you in the comments below. If you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, of course, I'll link it in the description as I always do. And if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.